Salamalaykum Warahmatullah. My name is Kumal Rizvi, and today you will join me in a brisk yet meaningful narrative of the history of Islam. Factual promptness in the contemporary world has unfortunately become meaningless. The average person knows very little of historical secrets and events. This video is meant to portray an accurate, unbiased analysis of the history of Islam. The beautiful and miraculous journey of the Holy Prophet starts on the 17th of Rabiul Awwal, the year of the elephant, a date that corresponds to June 8th, 570 AD. One of the most notable events that took place during this year was the invasion of Mecca by an Abyssinian army led by the general Abraha. The attempt to capture Mecca failed, as reported in the following verses of the Holy Quran, and he sent against them flights of birds, striking them with stones of baked clay. Then he made them like an empty field of stalks and straw, all eaten up. This can be found in chapter 105, and the verses are numbered 3, 4, and 5. Since the invaders had bought some elephants with them, the year of their campaign came to be known as the Year of the Elephant. The invading army withdrew from Mecca, and the terms of truce were negotiated on behalf of the city of Mecca by Abdul Muttalib alayhi salam. The Prophet was born in Mecca. It has been noted that Abdullah alayhi salam was the favorite son of Abdul Muttalib. When he was 17 years of age, he married Amina alayhi salam, and she was a high-born lady of Yathrib, which today we call Medina. Abdullah alayhi salam was not destined to live long and died only 7 months after his marriage. It was Abdul Muttalib, the Prophet's grandfather, who gave the Holy Prophet the name Muhammad. For the first 4 years, the Holy Prophet lived in the desert with Halima Sadia, a woman of the tribe of Banu Asad, living in the east of Mecca for nursing. Sometime in the fifth year of his life, Halima is reported to have brought him back to Amina in Mecca. Sometime in the sixth year of the Holy Prophet's life, Amina alayhi salam passes away. It was then that Abdul Muttalib promised his guardianship and took the Prophet to his home. Only 2 years had passed when Abdul Muttalib also died. Just before his death, Abdul Muttalib alayhi salam called all his sons together and told them that he was leaving two bequests or requests for them. One was the leadership of the clan, Banu Hashim, and the other was the Holy Prophet, an orphan of 8. He then asked them who among them wanted his power and authority as the leader of the tribe, and who among them would take charge of the boy. Most of the sons showed much eagerness to be named the leader of the tribe, but no one volunteered to take charge of Muhammad. Abu Talib alayhi salam, one of Abdul Muttalib's sons, stepped forward and said he wanted the son of his late brother Abdullah, but he had no interest in authority and power. Abu Talib's forthright declaration clinched the matter for Abdul Muttalib. He decided to make Abu Talib alayhi salam not only the guardian of the young boy Muhammad, the Holy Prophet, but also the guardian of the clan of Banu Hashim. Abdul Muttalib announced on his deathbed that his son Abu Talib would succeed him as the new chief of Banu Hashim, and that he would also be the guardian of the young orphan Muhammad, the Holy Prophet. He then ordered the assembly to acknowledge Abu Talib alayhi salam as the new leader of Banu Hashim. The latter complied and were then dismissed. Now, something interesting to note is that Abdullah alayhi salam and Abu Talib alayhi salam were born from the same wife of Abdul Muttalib. Abdul Muttalib alayhi salam was also the father of Hamza, the hero martyr of the Battle of Uhud, and he was also the father of Abbas as well, the forebearer of the Abbasi Khalifas in Baghdad. Abu Talib alayhi salam, during his incumbency as the leader of Banu Hashim, bore the titles of Lord of the Quraysh and the Chief of the Valley. In every season, Abu Talib alayhi salam's caravans left Mecca for their various destinations. Occasionally, he himself accompanied a caravan to supervise the sale and purchase of merchandise in the foreign markets. The Prophet is reported to have traveled with him to Syria with one of his caravans when he was 12 years of age. Early in life, Muhammad, the Holy Prophet, built up a reputation for truthfulness, integrity, and sound judgment. Since there were no banks in those days, he became a banker for the Meccans. They bought their cash, jewelry, and other valuables to him for safekeeping, and whenever they wanted anything back, he returned it to them. They called him Amin, which means trustworthy, and Sadiq, truthful. Thus respected and honored, the Holy Prophet lived a quiet and retired life in the family of Abu Talib. It is important to note that the Holy Prophet had participated in a war when he was 20 years of age. A war broke out between the Quraysh and the tribe of Hawazin. Though he was present in the campaigns of this war, he did not take part in any of the fighting. He did not kill or wound anyone, thus showing at this early period his hatred for bloodshed. He is, however, said to have picked up arrows from the ground and had given them to his uncles who were fighting. Moving forward, a few years later, Muhammad, the Holy Prophet, was admitted as a member into the League of the Virtuous. This league had pledged himself to protect the weak, to oppose the tyrants and oppressors, and to put an end to exploitation in all forms. Meanwhile, Khadija alayhi salam, the daughter of Khuwaylid, after the death of Khuwaylid, Khadija alayhi salam took charge of the family business and rapidly expanded it. With the profits she made, she helped the poor, the widows, the orphans, the sick, and the disabled. If there were any poor girls, Khadija married them off and gave them dowry. One of her uncles acted as her advisor in business matters, and other members of the family also assisted her in the management of business, if and when she sought their assistance. But she didn't depend on anyone else to make her decisions. She belonged to the tribe of Quraysh and was held in high esteem by the Meccans because of her exemplary character and her organizing ability. Just as the Meccans called the Holy Prophet Sadiq and Amin, they called Khadija alayhi salam Tahira, which means the pure one. She was also known amongst the Arabs as the princess of the merchants. Whenever the caravans left Mecca or returned to Mecca, they noted that her cargo was larger in volume than the cargo of all other merchants of Mecca put together. When the Holy Prophet was 25 years of age, his guardian Abu Talib alayhi salam suggested to Khadija that she appoint Muhammad as her agent in one of her caravans, which was ready to leave for Syria just then. She agreed and appointed the Holy Prophet as her agent. He took charge of her merchandise and the caravan set out for Syria. Her slave Maysara also accompanied him and served him as an aide. This commercial expedition to Syria was successful beyond expectations, and Khadija was so impressed that she decided to put the Holy Prophet in charge of all of her future business transactions. The expedition also proved to be the prelude to their marriage. Before I continue, I would like to pay respect to the men who read and assimilated the vast quantities of details through which today's discussion is possible. It has been noted that some devoted their lives and fortunes to the study of Islam. To them, the Muslim nation owes a profound debt of gratitude. May Allah bestow His mercy and blessings upon them all.